We've only got 1100 volts on our electric fence right now, and we've got to figure out what's wrong with it. It's Rye from Dattle Family Farms, and we've got 4 to 5 miles of electric fencing on our farm by the time you consider the perimeter fencing around 300 acres. Plus, we've got a bunch of different cross fencing as well. Our electric fence runs over and under 2 different roads. It's broadcast over 300 something acres. And so trying to find the problem with the electric fence over that much acreage can take a lot of time. So if we can hone in on where that problem is, it makes things much faster. In this video, I'm going to share with you some tips and tricks on how we do that more quickly here at the farm. I must admit though, this is not my idea. My dad set up the fencing on the farm so that he could isolate the problems quickly and easily, and it saves a lot of time. So the first thing that we're going to do is figure out what side of the road the short is on. When we've got a short and electric fence, this is one of the areas we look to first. This switch right here carries the power around the area south of Dattle Road. The area north of Dattle Road over here is 100 some odd acres of pasture and woods combined. It's where the pigs are right now and also where the cows are. So we've got the power off on that fence. We know that the power was only about 1,000 to 2,000 volts at the end of the electric fence north of Dattle Road. So now what we'll do is we'll check the power with the fence switch on, and then we'll check the power with the fence switch off that goes across Dattle Road and see what kind of voltage we're getting here. The Gallagher fault finders are expensive, but they're really worth their money, in large part because it's showing that there's a 4.6 kilovolt charge on the electric fence. And it's showing the top number there showing 25 amps, 28 amps. It jumps up to 30 amps every now and then. And it's got an arrow showing that that's the direction of where the fault is. If I go to the bottom line, it only shows that the voltage is down. It's showing 6,000 volts, but no amperage draw. So right here, it's showing that there's a fault north of Dattle Road. So now that I've got the power off north of Dattle Road, it's now showing 10.9, 11 kilovolts. So it's showing an 11,000 volt charge. So I know without a shadow of a doubt that the dominant voltage drop is north of Dattle Road. So this is usually where I check for voltage first when the problem is north of Dattle Road. There are 3 or 4 reasons for that. First and foremost, it's easy to access with the four-wheeler, and I can walk from the truck here as well. The power comes down that direction about 1/4 mile away. And also right here, there's a pig fence in the woods. They're low to the ground and there are often problems there. However, that fence is off right now, but I'm gonna go on and check the voltage here. No. Incidentally, when I came through here a moment ago, I forgot to turn the fence on. So I know that there's a problem to my right, but if you see that shows the problem, there's still a problem down to the left. But the voltage here is 4.5 kilovolts. So this is why these fault finders are helpful, but they don't always tell you exactly where the problem is, because there can be a problem before you get to where you're testing the voltage. And indeed there is. Like I said, I just drove through there with a four-wheeler. You can see there's a tree down right there and there are a couple others. We're gonna go take care of that and then come back and test the voltage again. Incidentally, you can remove stuff like this with the fence on. The fence is on at the moment. Usually we don't have to remove it unless the insulators here are broken. This one is broken and the fence is shorting out on the T-post there. So I am gonna have to turn the fence off to fix that part of it. But once I do that, we'll come back and check the voltage. Right now the voltage is reading 4.9 kilovolts. So the wire was grounding out on that T-post. However, that was not the primary problem. This TaylorMade fence charger has a 30 joule output. So before we go and check the rest of the fence, let's just go see what removing that one short did to the terminal end where we tested the fence earlier. It's 1.2 kilovolts. So it's 1200 volts. and 2.3 kilovolts. So really we just brought the voltage up by half a kilovolt or so, by 400 or 500 volts, not a whole lot. So even though we've cleared one major short in the electric fence, there's still a lot more going on. I don't know if you can hear the clicking, but the fence is shorting out right here. So this is a good example of a feed that could have taken a long time to figure out where the problem was. What I should have done is checked the voltage right there. The power comes across the road and goes around the perimeter of the fence. However, right here along Dowdle Road, there's a short 500-yard section or so that's fed directly from that area right there. One of this dividing paddock here is connected to that. So I could have fixed every single problem around the perimeter fence and not resolved this problem here. I'm glad I thought about this before I ran the fences. So I'm going to fix this and then we'll go from there. So the power of the fence is on. I've got this set of Crescent fence tools. The handle, they say, is not shockproof, and they are right on that, but a lot of times you can get by with it. If this were voltage that could really harm me, I would not be doing it this way. But a lot of times you can get by what I'm doing here without having to run and turn the fence off. Again, we're in the same spot where we've been checking the voltage the whole time, and we're showing 2.1 kilovolts on the top. So now we're up about 1,000 volts, 4.1 kilovolts. So that leads me to suspect that the problem is along this top wire. And I know that the power for the pig fence right now is coming along that top wire. So we'll go check it out now. So I just replaced this insulator here. This was the last place on this pig fence that had a short in it that I know of. I haven't checked the voltage yet, but I forgot to video it before I pulled up and fixed it. That's what the end of this fence is reading, 4.7, 4.5. See, now that top wire that was reading about 700 volts below is reading more voltage than the bottom wire, but we still have shorts on the electric fence. So now we're gonna go back and just ride the whole fence. I'm sure there are some trees down on it or something that are dropping the voltage some. I've already fixed 5 problems on the electric fence, but right here, 3 of these 4 wires are grinding out on the T-post. The fence is on right now, so I'm gonna come back after the fence is off to take care of this, but I'm gonna keep riding this fence to see where there are other problems. Another problem that needs to be repaired is this right here. If you look carefully, you can see that the insulator is supposed to be tied to the post there, and then the wire that's on that electric fence is just a jumper wire, much like these others on the other lines. I will fix that when I come back with some insulators once the fence is off. This isn't causing the fence to short out, but it is a problem that needs to be repaired. So I fixed these last 2 problems on the electric fence, and now the voltage is reading over 6,000 volts. That's good enough to keep both cows and pigs, especially if the pigs are trained to the electric fence. However, on this day it was rainy and cold, and especially in rainy weather, the voltage on the fence will often be 1,000 or 2,000 volts below. So in conclusion, it's worth noting a couple things. First and foremost, if you have a simple electric fence, you can usually find the problems pretty easily. But if you have a lot of fencing, 13, 14, 15 miles of it, and especially if it's branched off like ours, and so you have different paddocks and sub-paddocks, then it's really good to test each of those individual lines of the electric fence. So now we're going to bring the cows right here into the front of this paddock so we can move them south of Dowdle Road. I hope you enjoyed this video. Like it, share it with your friends. Do you use electric fencing? If so, let me know what kind of electric fencing you use. Until next time, take care. Hope you have a great day.